2019 was devoted to test the model. We took benefit of several national events in Italy, Greece, Spain, the Netherlands, and also Serbia to conduct workshops shaped by the model. We run a full safety culture assessment within the Danish company Norgiske Jernbaner. With the support of our partner ICSI, the Institute for an Industrial Safety Culture, we developed and tested a safety climate survey based on the model. We then conducted focus groups and we were able to develop the safety culture picture of the organization, highlighting cultural strengths and areas for improvement. We also worked closely with national safety authorities in Finland, Ireland, Switzerland, which tested the integration of the model in their regulatory and supervision activities. Traficom performed an extensive pilot and provided us with a detailed feedback that we used to establish a second version presented during the World Conference on Railway Research in Tokyo in October last year. The result is a European Railway Safety Culture model that I'm now going to detail. First building block of the model, which is central, the behavior patterns. Behavior patterns encompass those shared ways of thinking and acting that characterize the organizational culture. I have selected two examples that can be designated as cultural, especially by an external observer. The first one shows a shared behavior that clearly goes beyond the scope of a railway company. You can see all these people trespassing on the railway. The second one is a famous Japanese pointing and calling, here with a train driver. It also applies to other railway professionals, and although first used in railways, it has been successfully exported to several hazardous industrial contexts in Japan. Two observations. While these two examples show visible and shared behaviors, they require further inquiry to explore the motivations and meanings. This refers to a multi-layered conception of culture, from very visible demonstration to less visible motivations. Second, if you are willing to say that one is good and the other is bad, I might agree with you. Although, have in mind that when you do this, you are already taking the safety lenses to observe and evaluate the organizational culture. We will see in the next slide how the European Railway Safety Culture Model allows and explains this shift. Second building block, the cultural enablers. Through which steps does organizational culture develop? The four enablers we propose are based on the process presented by Frank Goldenmund. It all starts with individuals interacting. Interactions between peers, hierarchical interactions, interactions with or between contractors and companies, or with the authorities. Formalizing is key in our modern organizations, and I started this presentation mentioning the central role of the safety management system in our railway sector. Training and communication are disseminating activities from which one may expect changes and adaptations at both individual and organizational levels. Last but not least, reinforcing, which includes those specific attitudes and behaviors of the company leadership that potentially strongly influence the staff. These four cultural enablers generate the patterns of thinking and acting that characterize the organizational culture. Third building block of the model, the four railway safety fundamentals that we believe must be fulfilled by any rail organization to achieve sustainable and safe performance. First fundamental is the control of major risks. This means that major risks are identified and understood by all staff. Risk management not only relies on anticipation, but also on resilience, a concept that has been recently put forward. It also requires that a questioning attitude permeates the organization. Second and central fundamental, understand workplace reality. It is based on the ergonomist distinction between the task and the activity, meaning that any activity can never be entirely specified. Gaps between what is expected and what is performed will always exist. Finally, safety and operations cannot be managed from an ivory tower. This fundamental covers that working conditions are considered within a systemic approach to safety. Reporting from the workplace is actively and effectively encouraged. This reporting clearly supports analysis and improvement. Despite competition, railway companies must exchange safety information and learn from each other's practice. They should even learn from other sectors. This is a third railway safety fundamental. The first fundamental stresses the need to integrate safety consistently. This requires that safety is part of the organizational vision. Safety is not a standalone activity. It is integrated in the company strategy, in the allocation of resources. It is considered in the decision making. All the components come together in this visualization. The blue part shows the development of organizational culture, the value-free part, reflected by shared ways of acting and thinking. If the railway safety fundamentals are systematically implemented in the enablers and accomplished, the organizational culture will become a positive safety culture. Experience from all domains prove that this also brings business excellence. In a way, this comes with quality, punctuality, and profit. This first presentation helps building a common understanding of safety culture and how it develops. I briefly explained the four railway safety fundamentals. In a more detailed version, each fundamental is broken down into three attributes, as you can see. It would take too much time to detail and explain each of those. That is actually the purpose of some workshops we are conducting. I invite you to consult our website and download the first guidance we published last month. The same exercise was done for the cultural enablers. This led to 12 additional attributes that are as well described in these guidelines. In total, these are the 24 attributes of a positive railway safety culture that we use as an evaluation framework to assess the safety culture. We did it in NJ in Denmark, our Finnish colleagues did it as well, and currently, ADIF in Spain is designing tools based on the model to perform a similar assessment. How to integrate the assessment results in a cultural change strategy is clearly one of our topics of interest. Peer review is an arrangement that has proven to be very powerful in other domains, especially in the nuclear, and we are working in adapting such a solution for railways. We are cooperating with national safety authorities to better integrate safety culture in their supervision programs. Also, based on the model, we plan to launch an ambitious and broad survey next year during the European Eurotrail, targeting all European railway professionals. Other related activities deal with safety leadership, just culture, human and organizational factors. Guidelines and trainings are important deliverables of the program. One key principle is that these are all designed jointly with stakeholders. We are also conscious of our important role to raise awareness of safety and safety management. The agency organized the first European Rail Safety Summit 2 years ago in Croatia, during which a safety culture declaration was issued and which is now signed by more than 160 European rail leaders. Lastly, we will issue a report to the European Commission by 2024 on the development of a safety culture within the single European railway area. So, in a nutshell, the European Railway Safety Culture Model has been elaborated and tested with safety experts and rail professionals from all over Europe. One important feature when comparing with all other models is that it distinguishes and articulates the value-free concept of organizational culture with safety. It is practical, applies to any rail organization, still not oversimplifies culture and how it develops. It has proved to be an effective tool to evaluate, learn, and improve. For more information, do not hesitate to visit our website, contact us, or participate in the upcoming Q&A session. Meanwhile, I thank you for your attention.